competition just ingrained in us? We compete in all areas of life. You know, we compete for jobs, success. We compete in sports. We compete with each other, you know, to look the best. We always want to be the best, right? We want to be the best. But what about this competition we have with, like, being the victim? It's like, who has the shittiest life? Who has the most anxiety? Whose back pain is worse? My back pain is worse than yours. I have more anxiety than you. We have this competition just ingrained in us. Even driving. Oh, driving. When you're behind, like, a slow person and you get in the left lane to pass them because they're going 20 miles per hour in, like, a 55. And as you're passing them, they speed up. They speed up. Subconsciously, they speed up. They don't even realize it. And then you can't pass them because now they're going 55. Right? It's like the psychology of driving. I always thought that was crazy how people do that. And they don't even realize it. So, you know, yeah, we compete in sports. We compete to be the best, but we also compete to be the worst. We compete to show people, to get attention, saying, my life is worse than your life. The best is when I used to have my work schedule. I used to be off on Wednesdays, and I used to like to walk to the diner in town for a cup of coffee and get something. And it was funny because I got a glimpse of what it felt like to be like an old guy sitting in a diner. And sitting there, you overhear, you know, older people are always talking about like their medical problems or their doctor visits and what kind of medication they're on. I'm sure you've heard this. Were you people talking about like, oh, like my bunion is bigger than your bunion, or, you know, oh, my back pain. You hear somebody mentioning like their back pain. Suddenly the other person has back pain. Oh, like my cousin's mother just died. Then the other person had a death in their family. And it becomes this competition. And I don't know if it's a matter of us just as humans trying to relate to one another by revealing similar experiences, or is it more of a competition? It's like, my life is more important than your life. You know, we can't just sit back and be like, oh, I'm sorry that you have that, or I'm sorry that you're going through that. We always have to come back and react with something we're going through. Now, is that from a place in our heart, or is that from a place in our head? Is it from a place of competition? That is the true question. Is it coming from a place of competition? So the next time you're having a conversation with somebody and they bring something up and you just want to react, or you just want to spew back information about how you went through the same thing, how your dog just died too, or, you know, somebody says their mother just died and you're like, oh, my goldfish just died. That's not going to make the other person feel good, first of all. But try not to react and try not to give your story and just try to be understanding of the other person and empathetic towards the other person and not always try to compete. The next time you're driving, if that person who speeds up and pisses you off, try not to you yourself speed up and thus compete with them. See, we have just it ingrained in us. And then we become angry. If somebody's trying to outdo us or outpain us or outstruggle, you know, or they're more of a victim than us, then we always want to compete with that. Why? We always want to compete with that and say, no, my life sucks more than your life. I went through more abuse as a child than you did. It's like this seeking of attention that we have, seeking of attention. So observe this the next time this happens and see how that other person reacts to you. Because if it becomes a competition and you start talking about yourself, when a good friend of yours or somebody you know is talking about like how they were molested when they were 5 years old or something, and you come back and you, instead of just understanding that other person, you start talking about yourself. It's from your ego. From your ego. You say, oh, well, I went through that too. Yeah, there is something to be said that somebody can get something out of it. This relationship, like, that if I went through something similar, I can give you good advice. But initially, try not to. just try to listen to somebody and understand them instead of always using your ego and coming back and thinking that you need to compete with them in some way, or you need to bring up one of your old memories or traumatic experiences that you had and share with that person. You don't have to. What that person needs is comfort in that moment. What that person needs is compassion in that moment. They don't need to hear your big, long sob story. They don't. Maybe that can come down the line, but initially, no. If somebody's feeling very vulnerable or hurt and they're revealing something to you, make it all about that person. Give your energy to that person. Don't try to bring it back onto you. That's all I'm saying. If we can get away from this competing mentality in the world, things are going to run a little bit, things would run smoother. You wouldn't have so much fighting. You wouldn't have so much anger. It's okay in sports because that's sports. You got to win at the game, I guess, right? Although even sports get a little carried away, like with kids and stuff, the parents go crazy because they have to win, this win mentality, right? And this win mentality, it's like, we're winning. What are we winning at, really? What are we winning at? Because you're gonna win at one thing, and then there's just gonna be something else, and something else, and something else. So you're gonna just keep going through your life, fighting and forcing your way through, thinking that winning is the only cure, the only way to make your ego feel good, right? Well, yeah, it's a good way to inflate your ego, that's for sure. The true cure, the true path to just fulfillment in life is to be understanding and compassionate. It's not to compete with other people. It's to understand other people. So with that being said, I hope you got something out of this. I really do. If anything, just makes you think a little bit about just the psychology or how we do things just subconsciously, always. Whether it's from something stupid like driving your car to having a conversation about your medical ailments with somebody. Don't be that old person. Because what you're doing is just attracting the negative energy. If you're always talking about sickness, that's a whole nother video. If you're just talking about sickness and ailments and problems in the world, then that's your reality. That's going to become your reality. So we'll save that for another day. But I hope you all have a great day. If you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. I appreciate you all, and I will see you on tomorrow's video. So peace out.